It might swing a bit this morning, but looking to take advantage of this surface. Just one change for England.
He will provide a threat with a bit of swing. No doubt the likes of Dom Sibley maybe under a little bit of pressure.
And he will swing it. Look at that follow through. What about that for a follow through? Glide down to third man and it will bring four. England, four without loss.
Probing over from Trent Bolt in or around the sort of fourth stump line, forcing Rory Burns to play on that occasion. Lucky that this one sort of went straight down in the end. Like you say, guided it.
In the air, oh, just evading point.
It's going to go away for four. Sibley's first boundary, and it brings the crowd to life.
It's exactly what Wagner did. Doesn't find it easy to score through there.
Another nice shot through extra cover from Sibley as Wagner goes a little fuller. And two fours in the over for England and for Sibley.
Good batting, let the bowler come to you, see off the new ball.
Oh, he didn't know much about that, Rory Burns. He was aiming through square leg mid-wicket and it's found its way all the way down to the third man boundary, and that is a painful blow. D boards.
Again, very full from Wagner, some shape. And his hardest there into the boards, yeah.
That is absolute easy pickings for Sibley, exactly what you were saying, Nas. 50 comes up, 52 without loss after 20.
That he loves to score. He had clipped a few off his hip here at Edgbaston in the last few years. 50 partnership.
The third man, just a delicate dab.
Under the impression initially that he didn't expect it to come back in as close to his body as it did, but he still managed to maneuver himself into the right position, face of the bat pointing down towards the ground. No danger.
Does it miss out this time? A couple of pies have gone down. Invest in NASCOIN. Extra cover. Four.
Edges that one away. Along the ground though, down towards third man. He'll pick up another boundary, Sibley.
Width. Just kind of pushed at it really, didn't commit. But it flew off that outside edge. Decent pace delivery there from Henry. I'll add to a bit of frustration.
Oh, is that an edge? It is. He's got the line, got the length, and Sibley has fiddled just outside the line of off stump. Blundell takes the catch. New Zealand strike straight after lunch.
Just fractionally back of a length. Ended up high on the bat. Just tried to draw the bat inside the line, didn't quite read that well enough.
Edge gone. Yeah, Dal Mitchell got great set of hands and Crawley's poor run continues. Wagner strikes New Zealand with a double blow after lunch.
And Wagner's come out straight after lunch. And that is a ugly looking shot. He's not going to be happy with that.
21-year-olds, they bounce back a lot quicker than 30, 35, 36, 37-year-olds. Edged and through the gap or over the top. Way to the boundary for four. Streaky from Joe Root.
Joe Root reaching for the wider one. Tried to just lean in and play a square drive. control, let it come, and was really pushing at it.
This time got in, beautiful line, beautiful length, didn't cost much at all. And Matt Henry got it on a string after lunch. The skipper goes now.
Here for New Zealand, three quick wickets, and they are bowling beautifully. That is a perfect outside edge. Excellent catch and height for Blundell and Henry.
Oh, nicely played. Just went with the swing, did Rory Burns. Picks up another boundary behind point.
Really let the ball come. Played it behind point. Try and get the hands through too early. Just a bit of a caress.
Well, that's a fabulous shot from Rory Burns. Brings up England's 100 in some style. Burns goes to 49. No problems with his rhythm or foot movement.
So we talk about with Burns, his rhythm is in place. And if it's not, if his rhythm isn't good, then and he's low on confidence, then he looks a completely different player. I just say that Zach Crawley is just struggling a little bit because he wants a score, as everyone does.
Oh, even better from Tate. Does well to dodge Rory Burns on the first run as well. Good teamwork in the end, but they're going to run for it.
And a bit of interest. So far, the cover drive off Matt Henry. A little back foot punch to bring up the half century. Latches onto that. Short ball. Sits up nicely. Burns just hasn't quite got up enough. Too easy. Swivels, times it well.
Nicely played. It's got a nice little back cut. Yeah! Well gone. Short, wide. He should have hit it, actually. He should have hit it back the same way he did a couple of balls ago. Unfortunately, Ollie Pope nicks one to the keeper. Bonus wicket for New Zealand.
Well, that's his aggressive intent. To a short, it was outside the off stump, and he thought, runs.
Oh. That's really well played. He gave himself enough room last time. Shot just lent on that bit of width that was there to hit, but he put it away beautifully. 139 for four. That's good bowling, it's well played. Soft hands, head was in a good position, that's why it goes down. Coming back at the bowler. It should go all the way. .152 for four.
Again, just a gentle push. Timing so good. More than likely that will go all the way as well.
And a double teapot from the bowler, Matt Henry. He can't believe it.
Found the gap. Matt Henry will not be smiling. Gone. fished that one. That was a bit wide above stump.
Very good catch, low to his left. I think it's the skipper, stand-in skipper, Latham. Been searching more in this innings outside off stump. He went searching here. That is an excellent low catch. A wicket just after lunch, a wicket just after tea.
Not too sure he intended that to go so far in front of square, but he gets one nonetheless. And he's gone. Faced six balls at Lord's, this time just a single delivery.
Set up beautifully, wide, have a drive if you want, and they're not dropping them in the slip cordon either.
Swung a long way down the leg side, started a bit too straight. Four more runs to England, off the pads, so nothing to the batsman.
Lawrence is the one batsman who's put back to ball, 32 from 36.
Squirted away between point and gully. Looks like the outfield has got a little bit quicker as the day has gone on. England go past 200, 203 for 6. And again, this time to the left-hand side of gully. Profitable over for England and for Ollie Stone, 207 for 6. Wait for the umpire's signal on this one. It's going to go away to the boundary. Now there's four runs to Dan Lawrence, who moves to 40, 211 for 6. Previous over, more orthodox to Dan Lawrence. And that's a miss for mid-off. Nice shot though, Lawrence moves to 44. That's a gorgeous shot. There was a misfield from Trent Bolt earlier on in the over, but he could do absolutely nothing with that. That was sweetly timed. Gone straight away. Richard Illingworth did not hesitate. There'll be a conversation between Lawrence and Stone. Excellent hand played by Ollie Stone. He only made 20, but he did arrest New Zealand's momentum. It's a good hand too from Ajaz Patel.
You're on screen now, Richard. Signal now.
Long off, long on. There's a push down the ground if he wants, and that's exactly what he does. Boy from Chingford, Essex, goes to his third half century in Test match cricket.
That's nice, lovely timing, new ball, races across the turf for four. Back to back again, whipped away for four. 246 for seven. It, Matt Henry, he likes it a lot. Behind the stumps, they're not too interested.
Richard, bat evolved, stay with your original decision of not out. I'll let you know when you're on screen.
Great character. Prepared, is it? Yeah, he's refuted straight away. I thought that one was paired. Let's see if I get this one wrong as well.
I'll let you know when you're on screen. You're on screen now, Richard. Signal now.
That is very nice. Down through long on. It should reach the boundary. It does comfortably. Boundary to Mark Wood. He's to 16. 254 for 7. And again, another drive. This time it's Lawrence. It'll pick up four down the ground. Wood through the last ball of the day. He does. They will walk off relatively happy, but I think all in all, a fairly even day's Test match cricket, haven't he?